Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, and I'm a lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia-free. So I wear these hoodies and other things, so put it on, so if somebody is interested, he will knock on my shoulder. I won't throw pearl before swine, as the two men in Gnezaret they were doing, and the local rabbi locked them in the silence of the graveyard. And in the Bible they say, Messianic views, that he had demons in his head, a saint possessing demon. So Jesus drowned 2,000 swine over there, that these swine, they did not appreciate the gospel, and that is their fate. They will die like those. So if you don't understand gospel and you twist it or you do it like the, you don't want to know it, then you will die like those swine. So this end of the age is approaching, which is next year, 14 May 2023, is supposed to be the end of the age. And atomic war could take place any time after that, not before. Now we expect on 14 November, which is 6 months before the atomic war, that the people who are the tares, sons of Satan, unfaithful to their tribal father and mother, they will be locked up in the silence of the graveyard. So, the Bible is very interesting, and Sikhism is of the highest order. So here I have made a t-shirt design on Sufi Muslim, and there it is, Sufi Muslim, and this will put in the, you will see it in that thing, but here it is, Sufi Muslim. So Sufi Muslims are very rare to come across, because the mullahs, they hate Sufi. They are Sufi, they are the sons of Allah. And their mullahs say, oh, Allah has no wife. And where from they getting the son? Allah has wife, but they are not bound like ours. They are free. The Allah's Shakti, our wife is Holy Spirit, which you use it after you have understood the thing, and they will give you all the information. Holy Spirit is common sense, we call it Shakti. So here's something I've written, I will go through it and see if you can understand it. Because gospel, or the good news, is the top root of the scripture, what you see with the two naked eye, scripture. So what is written in Quran or other holy books, the top root of that one, that bruiser, that bruiser, nectar, and nectar is his word. So his word is the life of the dead words or the scripture. So that's why Jesus, when he was preaching are teaching in the synagogue the scripture, and he was explaining to them everything about it. So he was par excellent expositor. But the rabbis were not happy. They wanted blind followers. Sorry, I go to sleep, you know, sometime. So, here is what I have written. And you can see it. It's the front, I made a t-shirt design. The front is common and the back is different, you know. It's my anointed bridegroom in our royal vineyard. So, if I put it like this, maybe you can see it, then I can read it for you. So here you are. This is the end of the what I've written, and now we can read it. And let me check the focus. Yeah, that's all right. So my anointed bridegroom in our royal vineyard, which is above. This is the royal vineyard, which is above the secular world. That's why Jesus said, I come from above. Above is the word of Sadhu, celestial word of Sadhu, this one. And this is blue of Rabbi, secular world. This is celestial world of Sadhus. So, here you have to enter this gate. You enter this gate if you have the Holy Spirit, which is common sense. Otherwise you are not, you can't find this gate. Saint Peter was outside this gate, outside here. And because he was at reached the gate of the of our Supernatural Father, you don't come empty handed. So he was given the key to the kingdom of heaven and hell. That means he had the power to kill people. But Saint did not. Saint, the rest of the 11, they were inside here. Saint. So here we have one father with all his sons. So much more you can learn. So the tribal seed is to be sown outside here and turn it into plant, which is twice born, bear fruit. Seed can't bear fruit, plant will. So that's why you have to turn it into this, twice born here. And here we have Nanak from India and all those people, and then Christ Jesus in the middle, and then you have all that thing, you know, it takes place. So the royal vineyard is above the secular world. The secular world is here, where you read scripture here. Law and Prophets for Saint John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. After that, our royal king, Christ Jesus, has opened this gate to the royal kingdom of God. So when you enter here, here you are among the company of the saints. So here we have one father of our soul, which is Allah, Parbrahm, or in these people call it God, G-O-D, God. But so let's carry on. Worship Allah within you. Allah is in here, not in heaven anymore. In truth and Holy Spirit, which is called common sense. So Peter was once born and he was sitting at the gate of the royal kingdom of God. So he was sitting at the gatekeeper. So as well as the somebody this. So worship Allah within you in truth and in Holy Spirit, which is Surti, or we call it common sense. Mr. Jat Ba'illah, a Sufi Muslim. Mr. Jat. My tribe is Jat. Illa is Jat. If you know Illa, then only you can know Allah. If you don't know your Illa, then you can't know Allah. Allah is Al-Illah, the Father. This is my secular father. Sufi Muslims are the sons of Allah within them. So Allah lived in his mosque, which is this one, made not by human hand, but by the Lord of the nature. So oh dear, sorry for you. Sleepy, huh? It's midnight. And so Sufi Muslims are the sons of Allah within them. Allah rests in the hearts of the tribal men. Ba'illah. Ba'illah means that we honor our tribal father. La'illah means that I have forsaken him. The Kaaba is the temple of Adam. Before that, the young boys, 12 to 16 years boys, they used to perform Hajj rites and they kept Kaaba to their right hand side and went 7 times around. That is Ba'illah is Hajj. And today they keep him on the left hand side, that we have left him. We don't have any tribal father. And they go around it 7 times. So unless you are born of water, you cannot be born of spirit. So putting on the right hand side is the correct way, not to the left hand side. There are many people who are not of Semitic race, who may be Aryan or some other race, and they still go there to get their blessing, but the Kaaba, the Hajj is of two types. One is of Shirikat and one is of Tariqat. In the Hajj of Shirikat, you keep it on the right hand side, then you are part of the your tribal family. In the Hajj of Tariqat, you want to get rid of those family people, you become solitary. You keep left hand side and you go around seven times as they are doing today, that is La Ilah. But unless you are born of water, you cannot be born of spirit. So that's why in real Islam, the boys about 7 to 12 years old, they kept Kaaba to their right hand side, going around seven times. Sufi Muslims are the sons of Allah within them. Allah lives in his temple, this one here, not in heaven anymore. So no more alienated. Allah rests in the hearts of the tribal men, which is Ba'illah. Okay, let's see. No faithful son of tribal father, illa, born of water. No faithful son of al-illah, which is Allah, our supernatural father of our souls. Sufis are taught by Allah from his al-kitab. Al-kitab is with Allah. When Allah is in here, then I read that Al-Kitab. If Allah is not here, you can't read it. So, no Christ in your heart, no gospel, or dead letters. Sufis go by Inshallah, free of the Sharia of Shia and Sunni, called INSHMULLAH. So these Sharia were made by Mullahs and divisions, Shia, Sunni, etc. In God, we have one Father and His Word is one also, not dividing anything like that. So that is Ba'illah. So, Sufis go by Inshallah, free of the Sharia of Shia and Sunni. Shia and Sunni are man-made, it has nothing to do with God. Sunni called Inshmullah. So it is they, Mullah, they run this Sharia that you are a Shia and the other person is Sunni, all that divisions to cause among us the friction. No faithful son of Al-Ilah, Allah, our supernatural father. So if you are not born of Allah, then you cannot be born of our supernatural father, which is Allah. Sufis are taught by Allah from His Al-Kitab. Sufis go by InshaAllah, free of the Sharia. So in Islam, it is submission to the will of Allah. And Allah can't bind you, because Allah is not letters, it is spirit. So of Shia and Sunni called INSHMULLAHs. I made it, this video in Punjabi also, in my own native language. So this is making it in English, so everybody can understand. That's a true InshaAllah Sufi Muslim. Number one, he had the sword, Haya, of his tribal father, Ilah. Nisaf Iman, half Iman, born of water. That's what Hazrat Muhammad said. So, John the Baptist was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, because they have broken their covenant with Abraham. And so, your own church is very nice, you know. So, four qualities Muslims should have. He had the sword, Haya, you look in the Sharam. Sharm, shame, or conscience of his tribal father, Ilah, Nisaf Iman, half Iman, born of water, semen, water is semen. He speaks the duplicity, free, truth. Peter was speaking whatever he saw, he will tell the, he won't add anything to it. So that is how the truth should be spoken, without duplicity, no confusions, straight what you have seen. That is the base of our absolute truth, which you receive it from Allah within your heart. He is contented with his lot, Haq Halal. He will always eat meat, eat Haq Halal. Not going around and begging for money. He speaks the duplicity-free truth, as Peter was doing. He is contented with his lot, which is Haq Halal, which is lot, Haq Halal. We say, you know, that eat what belongs to you. And don't snatch from somebody and call it halal. No. Only what you earn is by your own self is halal. Aurangzeb was a hypocrite, and he was started farming to produce his own wheat and other things, so that you can tell the people, oh, look, I'm not eating donations. It is all by myself. So, number four, he is the most merciful son of Al-Rahim, Allah. Al-Rahim, Allah is merciful. So if you are merciful, then you represent Allah. If you kill people, as they were doing in Iraq, Mohammedan were killing so-called Christian, cutting their throat, that is of Satan. That is Islam of Mullah, InshaAllah, not of InshaAllah. So son of Al-Rahim Allah is represented by mercy. So to be a Sufi Muslim is not a joke. Royal Shah Samast Brizi is my elder brother. Cool-headed, roomy, appreciated, inshallah, Islam. So, saltless, la illah, kafir, AL-DJMAR, AL-AKSA, are these people going to Hajj, which will include women, everybody, old and young, you know. Over there, they keep Kaaba to their left hand side. That means we have left the left Adam. Whereas when Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, they went their journey of Barak. Over there, they kept the Kaaba to their right hand side. So remember that the saltless, la illah, kafir, AL-DJMAR, AL-AKSA, this is the Satan, you know, which is not that powerful, is the middle one. INSHMULLAH killed him. So Mullah killed my elder brother, Raif Shah Shamit Tabriki. So let's see. Remember that the Al-Kitab, Oral Torah, his word, is the top root of the holy scriptures. Any scripture, you know, which you get, the top root is this. His word, which is the Oral Torah. So I have over 8,300 videos so far, and your contribution would be much appreciated. So here it is, the Islam of Allah. So anybody who stands between man and oh, there you are. There are a lot of videos I put on Hajj and other topics. And here I can show you some of these, my works. You have seen this, this is the below, this is the above. Unless you go above, you cannot preach gospel. Here people read the dead letters of the scripture, Luke 16, verse 16, John the Baptist. That is the end of the dead letters. Now it is time to go to this narrow gate of sadhus and become the mammon-free Sikh. Oh dear. So here is the relationship. In Adam, you have races, under races, you have tribes and other things. So you can see there's no Hindu, Sikh, or Jew over here. But if you put these scriptures up, Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, over to the, this side, then you will see that you block your people with the spiritual knowledge. So, the one causes problem when this spiritual self, these spiritual self, they are introduced here, then you part, made your covenant to Adam, and you become sons of the Most High Satan, religious fanatic, as they are in Jerusalem or in Israel gathered together. So these are the sons of Satan. This is AL-DJMAR AL-AKSA, very powerful Satan. And this one is also on my Hajj. This is the tree of life, scripture, what is written, Quran, Bible and everything. And this is the interpretation through His word, through Christ. So, here you are. This is the Jewish menorah in honor of Friday. This light middle one is of Elohim. So, in His honor, this is made short. And so, that's it. Our Father God blesses you. It's very simple, like ABC subject. So far you can control your mind and not go by what I say or somebody else says. You have to think yourself through intuition, because Allah is here inside. Talk to Allah and He will tell you everything. So don't worry about the name Allah, because most people, even in the Sikh temple, if I went there, I told them, sing ALLAH-HU-AKBAR. Oh, you are a Sikh, you are calling us that to say this Mohammedan saying of Allah? No, no, no way. That is the attitude towards, you know, of the stupid people. Such people have no common sense and they can't learn gospel. So our Father God blesses you.